was Halloween on Dark Railway, and the engines were getting very excited. I can't wait for tonight! It is tonight, Theodore! Oh really? Am I going blind? Possibly. Dave, who had been confined to the sheds all day with a broken cylinder, laughed heartily. Huh, is all that beer you drank this morning, mate? Dave laughed. Is there any left for us tonight? No, but young Alan said he'd bring in some for us. And on top of that, Brian said he'd tell us a story. The yard suddenly went very quiet indeed. All of the engines knew that Brian was the best storyteller on the line. Indeed, he had talked himself out of many jobs over the last few weeks, purely by entertaining Mr. Dark with his tall tales. Not much was said after this, as evening changed into night. Brian, the last engine to arrive back at the sheds, soon arrived after taking a heavy ballast train from Soma to the junction. As he rolled in, everybody watched him expectantly. Where's the booze then? Nobody replied. Oh yeah, I'm meant to be telling a story tonight, aren't I? Well, I did have this excellent one about some coal trucks, a vicar, and a small blue tank engine called, Brian. We need to give the viewers something Halloween-ish. How about a ghost story? Nah, they're for kids. But everyone's attention was suddenly on the big tank engine, and he laughed. Huh, fine, here we go. Long ago, far away, was a quaint little railway called the Sundale and Port Haven Light Railway. It wasn't a very long railway, or very profitable, but it was popular with the locals, who used it every day to travel from docks at Port Haven to the nearby mainline via the Sundale Valley. Anyway, the line owned one small engine called Pogo. He was a hard worker, but wasn't much of a talker. He just got on with his work and made no fuss. One day, the little engine was marshalling a train together at the docks. Barry, a visiting engine, laughed at him. Huh, what a waste of metal. You'd be better off in a scrap heap, mate. Pogo ignored him and got his van train ready to go. What he didn't realise was that these were no ordinary vans. They were loaded with smuggled gunpowder. Nobody bothered to check the vans. After all, it was only a small railway, hauling local passengers and goods, and the managers never bothered to log what was being transported anyway. Once the train was ready, Pogo set off up the hill, puffing very hard indeed. So hard, in fact, that hot ash and soot soon came pouring out of his funnel as he approached an old bridge. Halfway there, Pogo thought to himself. As he approached, he saw the engine that had teamed him earlier, with a train of empty trucks. Ha ha! Don't try too hard, or you'll chuck out your fire. Unfortunately, at that precise moment, a large chunk of hot ash flew inside one of the old vans behind Pogo. With a tremendous bang, Barry watched in horror as the bridge before him collapsed from the force of the explosion, sending Pogo, his crew, and the trucks plunging down into a deep ravine. Barry backed away, speechless, as he heard the pitiful moans and wails of the half-destroyed engine. He returned half an hour later, but by then, Pogo was gone from the world. 5 years after the event, Barry had left the Sundale line and moved on, forgetting all about the little engine he had seen being blown to pieces all that time ago. However, he was soon sent for scrap himself, his working life finally over. He knew, in his heart of hearts, that he was due to be cut up in a few days' time, and was feeling very depressed about the whole business. One night, as he waited up in the rail yard, he could hear a whistle somewhere nearby. Hello? Who's there? But the engine, whoever it had been, must have taken a different line, because he couldn't see a thing in the fog. Half shrugging, Barry tried to get some sleep. But rolling through the yard was a very familiar looking steam engine. But no, Barry thought, it can't be. He was destroyed. How could it be? Barry called out into the mist again. Hello there. But even as he said it, the engine quite simply disappeared. Now terrified of what he had seen, Barry closed his eyes, hoping that sleep would finally come for him. But something very different came for him, all right. He heard a wheezing sound in front of him. He opened his eyes. Standing in front of him, looking grim, was the little engine he had teased all those years ago. Barry couldn't say a word. He just shook with fear. How could this be? He thought. He was ripped up after the accident. But here he was, standing silently on the rails ahead. Was it a ghost? Pogo rolled forwards, towards Barry. He closed his eyes again. As their buffers met, the two engines disappeared silently, and the fog slowly lifted around them. And every Halloween, Pogo rides the rails again, looking to claim more battered, broken engines for its own, to take on to the next life, to the beyond. So, there you go. I hope you enjoyed it and... Alan snorted. That was a truly dreadful story. You'd have to be a complete moron to be scared of that. Wouldn't you say, Dave? Dave? Dave was in his shed road. He remained completely silent, looking very troubled indeed, as his eyes darted around the foggy yard. Brian laughed. Huh! Not afraid of a children's story, are we, Dave? But Dave didn't speak again for the rest of the evening.